out-of-bounds samples from the timeline. The feature Bounce the Timeline makes a recording from a certain part of your track and renders it as a new sample. To do so, adjust the loop markers to define the looping portion of the track. Next, click on the Project menu and select Sample Upload from the dropdown. Choose Bounce Timeline to proceed. In the Bounce Timeline dialog box, notice that the start and end positions have already been set to the loop markers position automatically. If you need to edit the positions, you can do so here. We highly recommend using the two-pass method, which applies reverb and delay from the end of your range to the start of the region. This technique helps to avoid abrupt transitions and hard cuts, particularly when you are bouncing loops. But first, click the Bounce button to initiate the process. Once the bounce is complete, click on Open Probe to open the resulting file for further inspection and adjustments if needed. So this is how the loop sounds without using the two-pass mode. As you can hear, the effect is not played back in the beginning of the loop. So let's try it with enabled two-pass mode. As you can hear in this run, using this feature is worth it. Smooth transition without any disturbing cuts. Next, click on the File menu and select Upload. You'll be prompted to confirm your agreement to the copyright terms. Click OK to proceed with the upload. Provide the necessary details for your sample. Write the name, description, and relevant tags. Once done, click Upload to complete the process. To find and access your uploaded sample, navigate back to the studio. Look for the My tab in the Samples section. Here you'll be able to locate and manage your uploaded samples. The bounced sample is now ready to use.